gallery is a very special gallery. The Whitechapel Gallery is a museum without a collection, which in a way is one of the things that is most exciting about the Whitechapel, because what it means is that every year we're able to invite and house a different collection from around the world that may have rarely been seen by the British public. And this year, for over a year, we've invited and teamed up with the Barjeel Art Foundation in Sharjah, which is the collection of Sultan Saud al-Qasimi.
Exhibition happening. So thrilled that London's able to see this collection. We're very privileged that there are collectors like the Sultan and the Barjeel.
Incredible, inspirational.
It's a magnificent collection.
Presenting a year of displays from the Barjeel Art Foundation. Our inaugural display, which opened last week, is already drawing 1,000 visitors a day. For his unwavering commitment to the arts, his passion for forming dialogue around the Arab art world's complex ecologies, for his generosity in hosting us here tonight, please join me in saluting the founder of the Barjeel Art Foundation, Sultan Saud al-Qasimi.
Thank you all for joining us today on this very special evening. Thank you, Ivana, for that wonderful presentation. Now, thanks to imperfect chronology, the exhibition as well as its publication, which includes no less than 8 essays, art from the Arab world is even more accessible to the public. After all, the exhibition realized that the Whitechapel, titled Imperfect Chronology, is unprecedented in its scale. Unlike other exhibitions that last for a few weeks or include a dozen or two artworks, Imperfect Chronology has mobilized over 100 works from Sharjah to London for a show in 4 parts that spans 15 months.
Sultan's efforts as an activist, writer, and commentator, in my opinion, and in many others, have always sought to unfold the complexities of so-called Arab life and society. The Barjeel project is part of a broader constellation of activities and a commitment, I think, really to change perceptions and to challenge our collective understanding of art's history.